بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. linear land markings. linear and band shadows normal structures such as blood vessels and fissures form linear shadow within the lung field. However, there is many disease process which may result in linear shadow. linear shadow are less than 5 mm wide. Band shadow are greater than 5 mm thick. Linear shadows and band shadows. Causes of linear lung shadows or marking: Cordes line, plate atelectasis, pulmonary infarcts, second fissures, pulmonary pleural scars, bronchial wall thickening, central lines, anomalous vessels, artifacts, curvilinear shadows like polypneumatocele, bronchoceles. Linear interstitial patterns are seen in the process that seeking axial bronchovascular interstitium or the peripheral pulmonary interstitium. Axial diffuse thickening along bronchovascular tree seen as parallel abscess radiating from the hilum. Seen transversely or peribronchial coughing seen in face. Peripheral linear interstitial pattern thickening of the peripheral interstitium either medially or laterally produces Cordes line. Axial interstitial thickening is difficult to distinguish from airway disease that is a result in bronchial wall thickening like bronchiectasis, asthma, and most often seen in the interstitial pulmonary edema. Peripheral interstitial involvement seen in the interstitial pulmonary edema, lymphangitis, carcinomatosis, acute viral or atypical bacterial pneumonia. Atelectasis. Disc atelectasis, impaired diaphragmatic motion, lead to underventilation, collapse of small pulmonary subdivisions and Fischer's line formation. This is examples of atelectasis. Linear transverse marking at the lower lung, at the base. Plate-like atelectasis is a common find in chest X-ray, detected almost every day. They are characterized by linear shadow of increased density at the lung bases. They are usually horizontal, measure 1 to 3 mm in thickness, only few centimeters long. In most cases, this finding have no clinical significance and are seen in smokers and elderly. They are seen in patients that are in poor condition and who breathe superficially, for instance, after abdominal surgery. Plate-like atelectasis frequently seen in patients in ICU due to poor ventilation. Plate-like atelectasis is frequently seen in pulmonary embolism, but since it is non-specific, it is not helpful sign in making diagnosis of pulmonary embolism. Examples of plate-like atelectasis due to poor inspiration in patient who had abdominal surgery. Plate-like atelectasis in a patient with pulmonary embolism. Plate-like atelectasis in chest BA radiograph, bilateral discoid plate-like atelectasis. As we see, straight arrow indicate typical appearance of this is abnormality that's commonly found in post-operative, post-trauma, severely ill and debilitated patient. Bronchial thickening, periprochial thickening, periprochial coughing results in fluid seeking the bronchial wall become visible, producing donut-like densities in lung parenchyma. Second bronchial wall parallel streamline shadow, ring shadow in on the face view. They are common finding in bronchiectasis, recurrent asthma, bronchopulmonary aspergillosis, pulmonary edema, lymphangitis, carcinomatosis. Prebronchial coughing represent extravasated water surrounding bronchus. Periodiasis, not the coughing, both diuresis. Central line, an unusual sign of lower loop contraction. Mucus filled bronchi, coarse lines laying peripherally on contact with pleura and curving upward. Often left sided and associated with left lower loop collapse. They may default due to kinking of bronchi adjacent to the collapse. It is various densities occurring at the lower zone of the standard PE chest radiograph. This one sign may be ignored. Central lines. Central lines, coarse linear densities at the base may be due to adjacent lower loop contraction. The usually superior and inferior branch of lingual bronchi. Densities probably due to mucus filled bronchi or alveolar atelectasis, distal to kink, resulting from poor bronchial drainage and they may indicate more extensive disease. The left lower loop collapse may not be visible in chest radiograph, but the presence of these densities should alert observer to the more important associated abnormality. This is linear density at the left base. Line is semi-horizontal, concave upward, left lower loop collapse. The line no longer present, the lower loop has re-expanded. This is several horizontal densities at the left base. Triangular shadow of the contracted left lower loop just visible through the heart shadow. This is several long horizontal densities at the left base. This is upper horizontal line crossed by curved oblique line concavity facing the mediastinum. This is a group of horizontal curved lines at the left base concavity facing upward. This sentinel lines. Linear density at the left base, semi-horizontal concave upward, left lower loop collapse. Here not present because lower loop re-aerated. This is example several horizontal lines we see before. At the left base, triangular shadow at contracted left lower loop just visible through heart shadow. As we see, this is linear discus, small distal branch of lingual bronchi. Several long horizontal density at the left base, which we see before, as this is left lower loop contracted and bronchiated. This is a group of horizontal curved line, as we see, concavity facing upward. This is sentinel lines, mucus filled bronchi, bronchocele, typical gloved finger branching better, gloved finger branching better, sentinel lines, careless line. Careless lines, septal line lung, pulmonary lymphatic usually not visible. Lymphatics drain the interstitial fluid and the foreign particles. They run in the internovular septa and drain to the hilum. Second, the lymphatics and surround the connective tissue. Careless line divided into three types. Careless A line, second deep septum. Careless B line, second internovular septum. Careless C line. Careless B lines, these are horizontal lines, less than 2 cm long, commonly found in lower zone peripherally. This line second edematous interlobular septa. Causes of careless B lines, pulmonary edema, lymphagitis carcinomatosa and malignant lymphoma, viral and mycoplasma pneumonia, interstitial pulmonary fibrosis, pneumoconiosis, and sarcoidosis. They can be even seen in X-ray of patient in and out of heart failure. This example scales B lines at the periphery, PAs, perpendicular to pleural surface. Curlis AP line, C line difference. A line seen, non-branching, 2 cm long, 1-2 mm thick, radiating from hilum. Curlis B line, seen transverse vent, non-branching, 1-3 cm long, 1-2 mm thick. Lateral part of lung base, extending to pleura, common costophrenic angle. Curlis C line, fine interlacing line, seen throughout the lung, spider web-like appearance. Curlis E line, not follow course of artery, vein, or bronchi. Curlis B line, frequently seen than E and C lines. Lines arranged in steep ladder-like pattern, 0.5 to 1 cm long, always perpendicular to the pleural surface. This patient suffering congestive heart failure with Curlis B line at the periphery, horizontal, perpendicular to pleural surface, reaching pleural surface. This is, as we see, Curlis A lines. Curlis A lines approximately 4 cm length, almost conspicuous in the upper and mid portion of the lung. They are deep septal lines, radiate from the hilum into periphery central portion of the lung, do not reach pleura. Presence normally indicate more acute or severe degree of edema. Curlis ABC lines, as we see, this is Curlis A lines, and this is Curlis C lines, B lines. Curlis A lines, as we see, radiating from hilum to the center of the lung, not reach peripherally. Curlis B lines, as we see, reach peripherally, perpendicular to pleural surface. Curlis C lines, spider web or interlacing, it is superimposed Curlis B lines. Curlis B lines may be transient pulmonary edema, persistent dilated lymphatics, chronic interstitial edema, hemosiderin dust deposition, interstitial fibrosis, if persistent. Curlis B line may be transient or persistent, present in the base of the lung due to hydrostatic pressure and gravity. Difference between Curlis B lines and the blood vessels. Curlis E lines, as we see, A, B, C lines, this image. Curlis A lines, radiating from hilum into central portion of the lung. Curlis B lines, the periphery of the lung at the base, reaching pleural surface, perpendicular to pleural surface, horizontal. Curlis C lines, as we see, this is interlacing spider web of superimposed B lines. Causes of Curlis lines, pulmonary edema, pneumoconiosis, infections, lymphangiectasia, mitral valve disease, lymphagitis carcinomatosa, interstitial pulmonary fibrosis, lymphatic obstruction, congenital heart disease, sarcoidosis, alveolar cell carcinoma, lymphangiomatosis, pulmonary venous occlusive disease. Differentiation between Fleischer line, Curlis B lines, linear scar. Fleischer line, fewer in number, regularly placed, located deep in lung, thicker. Curlis B lines, more in number, regularly placed, 0.5 to 1 cm long, superficial seen. Linear scar may show fine strands emanating from border associated pleural effusion and permanent. Vascular lines. Vascular lineal lung markings, vascular indistinctness, water in the same density as vessels, so as to leave the vasculature full in the interstitium, that margins become fuzzy, crisp vessel margins, no edema, and we see here the edema. Vascular indistinctness, crisp margins, no edema, in this image we see edema. Cephalization, the upper loop vascular caliber is greater than the lower loop. This is present as linear lung markings. Cephalization means pulmonary venous hypertension as long, so long as the person erect in chest x-ray obtained. Curve linear density adjacent to the right superior mediastinum. Curve linear density adjacent to the lower right superior mediastinum with an wide lower density and its lower end. This is azygos vein. Azygos loop is common X-ray, normal variant up to 0.4% of individual. And you see in this case hereditary hemorrhagic lung ectasia or Osler-Weber syndrome, where you see mass in the right lower zone, mass sharp emergence, and two vessels supplying artery and draining vein, supplying artery and draining vein, leading to this mass present as linear lung marking. Anomalous pulmonary venous drainage, scimitar syndrome, scimitar sign, curve linear shadow in the right lower zone, it's called scimitar sign. Due to apparent drainage of right inferior pulmonary vein into inferior vena cava, this congenital anomaly, as we see, this is scimitar syndrome. This is linear, second linear lung marking, curved lines. Intravascular volume status, the vascular pedicle mediastinal width above top of the aortic arch represent superior vena cava on the patient right and to the left subclavian artery on the patient left. It is wide that indicate greater intravascular volume. Look at examples following slides. This is pre-dialysis, this is post-dialysis, intravascular volume status. This is linear marking within the IBC. And this is right side. And subclavian artery to the left side. Pulmonary infarction. Pulmonary infarction linear density. As we see, Western mark sign dilatation of pulmonary vessel proximal to embolism, along with collapse of distal vessel, often seen short off. Melting sign of healing linear scar. Pleural thickening or scar present as linear lung marking. As we see, spontaneous pneumothorax, ventrally seen lung edge. This is pneumothorax also in adult male patient. We see lung edge present as linear lung marking, ventrally seen. This is another case of the pneumothorax. We see this linear lung edge marking, lung edge present as linear marking and ventrally seen. This is X-ray. As we see, this is exposure to asbestos history, calcified pleural plaque present as linear lung marking. This is ventrally seen pleural plaques. This is also pleural plaques calcified, as we see, present on CT. Calcified pleural plaques present as linear lung marking. This is another patient with calcified pleural plaques. Calcified pleural plaques present as linear lung marking. Although we see density projected behind the heart, this is calcified pleural plaque. Old pleural and pulmonary scar, a scar and change in appearance in serial film, seen linear shadow associated with pleural thickening, tinting of the diaphragm. This is apical scarring, as we see, common with healed TB, sarcoidosis, fungal disease. Diffuse extensive pleural calcification present as linear lung density. This is also coarse parenchymal fibrosis, lung scar with right interlobular visceral break. Coarse parenchymal fibrosis. Bilateral symmetrical basal and pleural plaques. Bilateral symmetrical basal and pleural plaques present as linear density. Bilateral calcified pleural plaques, this calcified pleural plaques bilateral in asbestos. Lung scar, also like scar in the lung, like scar in the skin, permanent, cannot be removed. Present in granulomas, are scar caused by previous infections. Calcified scar present as in pneumonia, osteoplasmosis. Lung scar called also by silicosis, asbestos, sarcoidosis, cystic fibrosis, infection like pneumonia, TB, interstitial lung disease, pulmonary fibrosis. These examples of lung scar present pulmonary fibrosis, lung scar present as linear density, idiopathic pulmonary fibrosis, reticulonodular shadowing, as we see. radiation fibrosis linear marking, radiation fibrosis linear density, pulmonary fibrosis scattered bilateral throughout both lungs. Second, transverse fissure as linear density. Second, fissure linear density. Normal major fissure present, as we see, this is a major fissure right and this is left posterior to it. This is superior lateral major fissures, superior lateral major fissures present as linear density. This is vertical fissure line, the child with VSD, vertical fissure line, as we see, vertical fissure lines present as linear density. This is superior medial major fissure, superior medial major fissures present, superior medial right major fissures, minor fissure also seen as double lines. This is intrafissural fat, intrafissural fat, triangular ear increased opacity, intrafissural fat, minor fissure crossing major fissures, as we see, minor fissures, minor fissures crossing major fissures, this major fissure, linear density, right middle loop collapse, as we see, right middle loop collapse, right middle loop syndrome, as we see, all the major fissures, major fissure by this arrow, major fissures anterior to minor fissures, this minor fissure and this is major fissures, incomplete fissure sign, BA radiograph show curving interface in the lateral part of the left lower lung field with lateral opacity and medial lucency, incomplete fissure sign. As we see, right sided horizontal fissures, right sided horizontal fissures may incline superior laterally. Azygos fissures, as we see, formed by anomalous development of Azygos vein. Vein migrates through right upper loop, dragging parietal visceral pleura. Azygos fissures present as linear density. Azygos fissures, as we see, and Azygos vein. This is Azygos fissures, Azygos vein. Beak-like shadow along medial aspect of right hemidiaphragm. As we see, juxtaphrenic peak finding common in the upper loop collapse, upper loop collapse, what's called peak like shadow. This is formation of this peak thought to be related to the traction of the basal pleura by the inferior pulmonary ligament. Right inferior accessory fissures, right inferior accessory fissures present as linear density. This is fluid in major and minor fissures, the thickening of the fissures beyond pencil point thickness. Second, right interlobar fissure partially calcified, diaphragmatic plaque, as we see. Second, right interlobar fissure, interlobular fissure thickening, edema in the lung along the fissure. This is second fissure, also patient with pulmonary edema, congestive heart failure. Thickening of fissure, left sided horizontal fissures. Septal line, second interlobular septi, second interlobular septi. This is pulmonary TB sequel linear density. Kelvin linear shadow. Kelvin linear shadow, polypneumatocele bronchocele. Bullous disease of the lungs, definition, thin wall less than 1 cm, air filled space contained within the lung, 1 cm in size, when distended wall may be formed by pleura, septi, or compressed lung tissue. Differential diagnosis of Bullous disease is pneumatocele cavity cyst or PLEP. PLEP, intrapleural cystic space, cavity gas containing space in the lung having wall more than 1 meter thick. Cyst seen walled air or fluid filled with walls that contain respiratory epithelium, cartilage, smooth muscle, and gland. Pneumatocele seen wall less than 1 millimeter, gas filled space in the lung developing in association with acute pneumonia such as staph frequently transient. types of Ehlers disease, type 1 present subpleural, type 2 superficial spontaneous pneumothorax, type 1 present in paraseptal emphysema, type 3 deep within the lung. This is example of Ehlers disease of the lung with conventional NCT study. Ehlers disease of the lung, curvilinear shadow, curvilinear density. Pneumatocele are intrapulmonary air-filled cystic space that can have a variety of size, appearance, contain air fluid level, and usually result of ventilator-induced lung. You know, should be mistaken as cavitating lung tissue. Present in injury, neonates, or post-pneumonic. This is examples of post-pneumonic pneumatocele. This is post-staphylococcal pneumatocele, as we see, airfield space. Traumatic pneumatocele, as we see. Bronchocele, termed mucoid impaction, referred to mucus-filled dilated bronchi surrounded by aerated lung. Bronchocele, allergic bronchopulmonary aspergillosis, as example, bronchocele, mucus filled bronchi. Subtle increased opacification right middle zone, as we see, this is bronchocele. Calcified bronchocele, this is chest radiograph, show tabular branching opacity right lower lung field. Linear artifact, as example, this is curvilinear opacity in the right side with relucent lung lateral to it, simulating a pneumothorax, ill-defined opacification in the right mid and lower left lower zone. This repeat study, we don't find this present. Another case artifact simulating a pneumothorax in a patient following insertions of left internal jugular line. One can see lung marking the left side suggestive of pneumothorax. Another case of axillary skin fold simulating loculated left pneumothorax in a female patient non-breast carcinoma. Extension of resumed lung edge into axilla close to artifactual nature. This is examples bilateral curvilinear opacity in the lower lung zone. Simulating lung edge formed by anterior and oblique fissures, anterior and oblique fissures. This is closer inspections, as we see lung marking the lung lateral to resumed lung edge caused by oxygen reservoir bag, oxygen reservoir bag. This is edge of the reservoir bag simulating pneumothorax in 84-year-old and well patient. This is also chest radiograph show a linear shadow in the upper loop simulating upper loop diversion and fibrosis. Thank you very much.